Online banners. They're everywhere these days. Why? Because they work. Sitting in high visibility spots, making sure they capture the browser's eye when it wanders. Okay, time for you all to go. Eyes on me, people. Great banners invite viewers to learn more in a respectful and relevant way. Bad banners are like a noisy person in a quiet library. They're distracting and annoying, and we transfer that annoyance to the thing they're promoting. Out! Stick around and I'll show you how to easily make banners for social media and web pages in under 10 minutes. Hi, I'm John, a copywriter in design school here at Canva. Online banners, whether they're advertising something or just helping create a visual theme, are pretty common. We see them on the web, social media sites, in apps, they're everywhere. So it's surprising more people aren't using them to promote themselves or their business. Why is that? Do they think they're too hard to create? Maybe that was true in the past, but Canva makes it so easy and quick, you really have no reason not to banner up. Nice. Banner up. I just came up with that. Okay, before I show you how easy it is, make sure you subscribe to our channel. We're dropping new videos every week. If you're ready, let's jump into Canva. Starting on the Canva homepage, we'll type in banner. This brings up all sorts of banner templates. Different sizes, banners for wedding sites, social media headers, everything you could think of. The ones with crowns are for Canva for Teams or Pro subscriptions. The ones without are free for anyone. Look, this is how many templates are available for this search. That's a lot. We might need to be a little more specific. Let's try Facebook banner, otherwise known as a cover photo. Okay, this is better and a great way to show you how quickly you can customize a template. At Canva, when we talk about templates, we talk about starting inspired. It's just so much easier than starting with a blank page. And I don't care what you say, it's not cheating, it's efficiency. Okay, this is the template I've chosen. It has a professional business feel, perfect to promote my time efficiency classes. Watch how easy it is to customize. First, I'll upload my photo here. This image is already a frame, so I can simply drag in my photo like this, and it automatically replaces it. Now I'll change the text. You can see these text boxes are all individual. I'll add my text and I'm going to drop the size of this one so the hierarchy stays with the title of the classes. I'll change the color like this. Add in a description. Change this call to action and add in my website address. How easy is that? Now, this is ready to post. I'll go here and download this as a PNG file, like this. And then I can upload it to my Facebook as my cover photo. This is what it looks like. Nice. I'm ready for the inquiries to come flooding in. And now that I've got the base idea, Canva makes it really easy to resize my design so I can apply it to other social media platforms. What I'm about to show you is a Canva Pro feature. Of course, you can always sign up for a free trial. The feature is called Magic Resize, and with a few simple clicks, I can modify this design so it fits, how about a LinkedIn banner? Click the Copy and Resize button here, and Canva will make a new document for you using the correct size. Now, as you can see, I'm going to have to move some things around a little so I make use of the space. Move this here, this over here, make sure you leave some space for the profile pic, just finish this bit here. Okay, that's looking pretty good and a lot quicker than remaking it from scratch. This is how it looks in the wild. So that's how you would tackle the common social media banners and cover photos. But now it's time to introduce you to the three usual suspects of web advertising. The ringleader, Mr. Leaderboard, his lover and accomplice, Wide Skyscraper, and their trusty sidekick, Medium Rectangle. Together, they steal your attention whenever you go surfing across the web. There are many others in their gang, but these are the big players and the ones most people start with. To get started, let's see what happens when I use Magic Resize on the Medium banner. Again, it's got the right size, 300 by 250 pixels. So now I just need to move things around and make sure I'm using the space to maximum effect. Let me race through that quickly. Yep. Good. Alrighty, that's looking pretty good. You can see how quickly I could resize this ad to fit the leaderboard and skyscraper sizes. But I'm getting a bit bored with this business. It's time to change things up and get a new career. Drumroll please. Okay. Not quite what I was expecting, but I do appreciate a comfortable insole and a commanding heel. Let's jump back into Canva and make a leaderboard banner ad for my sensible office shoe store. I'll start on the homepage and type in leaderboard ad. You'll see that it's 728 by 90 pixels. There are a bunch of templates I could choose here, but this time I'm going with a blank option. The first thing you'll see is it's very thin. You really need to think about the hierarchy of your information here. What's the one thing you really need to stand out? Normally it's some text with high call to action value, or the logo. You'll need that to be prominent to build up brand recognition. What should be less attention grabbing? Normally the images. You need them on there, but with an ad of this size, they're there to support, not take over. Or the contact details. They can be pretty small, if you have them at all. Okay, that's looking pretty good already. Let me throw a colorful background in here. Great, that really helps the text stand out. And just like magic, I can resize it, turning it into a 160 by 600 pixels wide skyscraper banner ad. Again, I'll move a few things around. And there, we're all done. Because we're working in such a tight space, sometimes it's better to spread the information across a few pages. And we can utilize animation. This way you can put your ad into motion and really grab attention. It sounds complicated, but it's not. Let me show you how. I'll just head up here and duplicate the page a few times. Now I'll delete some of the information from here and really think about how the content is being delivered to the audience. Need shoes? And then on this page, need John. And then on this page, I'll hit them with the details, logo, and maybe another call to action. Don't delay, drop in today. Nice, that rhymes. Now I'll click on the background of this first page and hit the animate button at the top. Because I've clicked on the background, I can now choose page animations. I'm going with pan for this page. The next, I really want it to pop, so I'm going to choose the type and select the pop animation. On the final page, I'm going to select the background and this time choose a combination animation like fun. This combines a few different animations together. There's a lot of information on this final page, so I might just extend the timing a little. Just do that here. While I'm here, I might reduce the first two pages so they're more impactful. Let's see what it looks like by pressing this button. Nice. Now I'll need to save this as a GIF or an MP4. Just go to the Share menu, go to Download, select the file type, and hit this button. And that's it! You are now officially an online advertising expert. Well, not quite. But you know how to use Canva to build banners and promote your business through social media and web ads. I feel like I've only touched on the animation side of things though. You know you can even add video into your designs? That really grabs people's attention. Well, if you want me to show you how to do that, let me know in the comments and we can make another video to go a little deeper. Oh, and I didn't even show the animated elements you could use. And mobile banners and background remover. That's really cool. And then there's element sets. Oh, and the video. Did you find this video helpful? If the answer's yes, make sure you like and subscribe to our channel before you head off. We release new videos weekly, and I'd hate for you to miss out. In fact, you could check out some of them now. Here are a few of my faves. I hope you enjoy them. Thanks for watching.